If you can skate,
you can skate.
If you can shoot,
you can shoot.
Gay or straight, it doesn't matter, says this powerful new video. If you've got the talent, you can play professional ice hockey. But hostility to homosexuality in major male team sports, hockey, baseball, basketball, and others, means there are no active openly gay players in North America. A few have gone public after retiring, and they tell stories of fear, humiliation, and harassment.
For athletes who have to hide their sexual orientation on a day-to-day basis, that have to lie to their teammates and hide and live in fear of being found out, there's no way that they're playing at their highest level.
I'm Brian Burke, general manager of the Toronto Maple Leafs.
And I'm Patrick Burke.
The video is the work of Patrick Burke and his father, Brian, seen here marching in Toronto's annual Gay Pride Parade. His late son, Brendan, came out as gay in 2009. The You Can Play campaign is what Brendan himself wanted for the professional sports that he loved and worked to change. Elsewhere, some rugby and soccer players in Europe have come out, and dozens of Olympic athletes, including many medalists, compete as openly gay. North American men's team sports are lagging behind.
Sport is not progressive. It's not, it is a closed, conservative culture. But I think it's going to change very soon. I think we're on the verge. There are gay athletes in team sport. There have been forever. They've always been there.
And many think the brawling macho world of ice hockey might just be first. In the Toronto Gay Hockey League, founded 2 decades ago because of intolerance elsewhere, they look forward to their sport leading the way.
Hockey has changed dramatically. Out of all the big five sports in North America, I think hockey has the best chance to embrace a gay player.
Whether anti-homophobia campaigns spread to other sports remains to be seen, but it's probably just a matter of time before the first openly gay professional ice hockey player is playing on a rink somewhere in North America. Daniel Lack, Al Jazeera, Toronto.